Hello everyone and welcome back. We discussed the top three methods for creating new variables in Pandas in the previous session, which included the assign method. We will continue our discussion of the assign methods and its properties, as well as we will discuss why these properties make it one of the most popular way to create new variables in Pandas. The assign method is efficient and versatile during a sequence of multiple operations when used with method chaining. Moreover, it always returns a copy of the data, leaving the original data frame unchanged. Additionally, since the assign method returns a new object, the error setting with copy won't occur. Now let's do some examples. Let's import the necessary Python libraries for this session. They are Pandas and NumPy. The dataset that we'll be working with is W Superstore dataset. Let's use the Pandas read underscore CSV method to read it. To obtain general information about the Superstore dataset, one can use Pandas info method. As you can see here, the Superstore dataset contains 9,994 records and 20 variables. Furthermore, it specifies the variable names and data types, such as order ID being an object data type and order date being a date time data type and so on. The column names in the CSV file are in proper format with spaces between them, and some of them have dashes. Let me use this piece of code to tidy them up. This will generate camel format column names and replace spaces and dashes with underscores. Now let's use Pandas head method to view the first 5 records. And after doing some data wrangling, this is how our data looks like. Now let me demonstrate you how to add multiple columns to our data frame using the assign method during the data manipulation process. The goal is to extract the month and year from the order date column, as well as to create new columns from the Superstore dataset called unit price and target. I have created a subset of DF data frame named DF underscore subset that includes variables customer underscore ID, customer underscore name, region, order underscore date, product underscore name, sales, quantity, and discount. Now let's create new columns using assign method. DF underscore subset equal to DF underscore subset dot assign bracket open month underscore order underscore date equal to lambda x colon x order underscore date. I will call the DTSSR and then month. This lambda function will create a new variable named month underscore order underscore date by extracting the month information from the order date. Now let's create year underscore order underscore date equal to lambda x colon x order underscore date field. Let me call DTSSR and year. And this anonymous function will create a new variable called year underscore order underscore date and retrieve the year information from the order date field. Unit price is another variable we want to create. One can accomplish that by dividing sales by quantity, but there is an issue, and it is that some of the customers received discounts. In that case, first we need to calculate actual sales value, and we can do that by dividing sales by discounts. However, there is a small problem that not all customers receive discount. What does it mean is, if a customer has received zero discount and if we divide sales by zero, the result will be infinity. As a result, we need to impute infinity by sales and then we need to divide it by quantity. And this is how one can calculate the unit price. MSP is the new variable we are going to create for actual sales value. Lambda x colon x, let me call sales column, and divide it by discount. Now it is going to have infinity value because there are certain customers who does not receive any discount. I'm going to create MSP underscore final equal to lambda x colon. Let me call np.where method and let me call MSP equal to np.inf and I'm going to replace, if there is an infinity, I will replace it with sales value, otherwise it should be MSP. So our problem of infinity is fixed. Now I'm going to create a new variable called unit price, lambda x, let me call MSP underscore final and divide it by quantity. And this is how we have created unit underscore price. But I want it only two decimal places. What I can do is unit underscore price underscore final. It is an extra step, you can avoid it. np.round. Let me call unit underscore price. Two decimal places. And this is how one can calculate the unit price. One point is to keep in mind when you are using assign method to create new variables, and that is we cannot use the same variable name twice. Now we will create the final variable, and that is target. It is 15% higher than the actual sales value, which is MSP underscore final variable. Target equal to lambda x colon x MSP underscore final into 1.15. Let me call the round method from numpy, and that's it. One of the major advantage of using assign method is that it is effective and flexible when used with method chaining during a series of numerous pandas operations. Now let's see how we can drop unwanted variables such as MSP, MSP underscore final, and unit underscore price. Drop. Let me pass the list of unwanted variables, that is MSP, MSP underscore final, unit underscore price, x is equal to 1. And the final step is we are going to rename unit underscore price underscore final to unit underscore price. Let's do that. Rename columns equal to unit underscore price underscore final unit underscore price bracket close. And now let's run the code. And we have got an error. Now let's see what an error is. Quantity spelling. Let's see where we have used quantity. Here it is. Let's rerun the code. It is successful. Now let's view the first 5 record of df underscore subset dataset. Let's use head method. And you can see here, we have successfully extracted month information from order underscore date field. You can see the month is 11 in this order date 2020-11-08 and we have extracted 11. The year is 2020 and we have calculated the unit price as well as target. So the major advantages of using a sign method are it returns a new data frame so you can chain operation. It sidesteps the setting with copy warning completely. It makes your code look like a recipe. It forces you to think about the order of columns creation for dependent columns. It allows you to create multiple columns. And that is why the experienced data scientists and data analysts use assign method to create new variables in pandas. This example allows us to conclude this session. Moreover, I will write a community post informing you of the subject of the upcoming session. Take care now, guys, and have a great day.